Hi everyone, this is Ambroise from Motoplaisir Motorcycle Rental in Geneva. In this video, we are going to look at these two 1250 RTs. This one is the 2021 model and this one is the 2020. We will have a look at four things that are, in my opinion, good improvements and four things that I regret a little bit. So let's start with the four good improvements, in my opinion. First one is the design of the bike. It's a good facelift, in my opinion. This new 2021 RT looks a little bit like the 1250 RS. And so that's a good point, good improvement over the previous RT, which has been the same since 2014, quite a while. The mudguard is a bit different too, make it look a bit lighter. From the design point of view, I forgot to mention the integration of the adaptive cruise control sensor. It's quite well done on the RT, it looks okay. This is going to give a lot of work to designers because it's not that easy to integrate that flat rectangular piece of equipment on the front face of a motorcycle. Here, the fact that now you have this gigantic screen that is also the screen of the GPS. You get rid of the upper part of the dashboard here. So that's a good point. This was part of an optional package, and even if you put an external GPS, you have that in the way because of the optional packages that include things you don't need with the BMW. So that's a good point from the design point of view. The second good improvement is the screen. The screen that is so big, you can split it like this, and you can display a lot of information. You can now even display the map of the GPS. So that's a good improvement. The third great feature is now the GPS that you can have full screen here on the dashboard thanks to the BMW connected app. So that's great. For the first time, in my opinion, we are close to get rid of the external GPS, the dedicated device, because the BMW connected app has been very well designed for motorcycles. You can have the winding route option. The GPS selects automatically interesting routes, winding roads. You can also import GPS files, so you can prepare your trip with Google Maps or on your computer with a dedicated software, and you can import the file to your phone and then you follow the track on the bike. So for the first time, maybe I will get rid of the TomTom Rider that is mounted here on the 2020 model. Last interesting upgrade, new feature, is for the first time, and I think it's the first time in the motorcycle industry, you now have a phone charger, wireless phone charger, here in the bike. The compartment is closed, it protects your phone, no wires flying, just put it here and it's charging. That's really a great feature. I've been waiting for that for a long time. because on the new GS, okay, you have a USB plug somewhere, but wires that are flying everywhere during the ride, it's not perfect. So for the first time, you have a phone charger, very convenient. What you can hear is the compartment is air-cooled. You can hear a vent here. Because when you use your phone while charging wirelessly, sometimes it gets too hot, sometimes it's frozen because of that. So that's why BMW is cooling the compartment. I don't know if it will be enough during the summer, 35 degrees, using the GPS like this. Wait and see what's going to happen. So that's 4 improvements. Now let's have a look at 4 things that are not that great, that are not improvements compared to the previous generation. Let's start with the control of the heating. So let's have a look on the new RT. To be able to set the heat on the grips or the seat, you have to go in the menu, settings, then you choose heating, sorry, it's in French, and then you choose grips or seat. You choose, and then you rotate the wheel, and then you click OK, and it's only now that the seat is heating. On the previous RT, it was a bit easier and quicker in my opinion. So you just had to press the menu button to display the right page. Okay, so it can be the grips or the seat. And then you just had to rotate the wheel and you're done. And still you have the speed, tachometer, and after a few minutes, if you want to turn down the heat, no problem. You just rotate the wheel down. Nothing else to do. You could have even set a shortcut pressing up here to go directly to the page you want. So it's currently set to the suspension, but we could have set that to the heated grips like this. You just press and hold here. And like this. Now it's off. So the controls of the heating is not that great. Fortunately, on the 2021, you have a shortcut here. So you press this button. And you can see that sometimes it does not work. Okay. So this is the screen. You press the shortcut, number 2. And here you have access to the settings. You push the wheel, you rotate the wheel, and then you have to push again, and now it's set. But you have this screen now, so you have to press back up once and twice to have your display back. So in my opinion, it's not great. Second thing, it's related a little bit to the same problem, is the control of the suspension. So now to access the settings of the suspension, same thing, you have to go to the menu, settings. It's not in the vehicle settings, but here in the assist menu. And here you can set the dampers to dynamic or road. So again, during the ride, it's not that easy. If you have to be focused on the road, not great. Of course, you can change here the riding modes and changing the riding mode, you will change the setting of the dampers. But if you want, let's say, a dynamic engine and a normal or road suspension, you have to go in the settings. Compared to the previous bike, to the previous generation, 2020, here you can see the setting of the dampers, the setting of the preload, and this is the riding mode. You can very easily, you press the menu button, and here you have the setting of the dampers. When the bike is stopped, you have access to the settings of the preload. So it was a bit more straightforward on the previous generation than on the new one. Okay, probably most people don't use that, and most people just choose the riding mode that does everything for you, and you leave the preload as is on auto. So I regret a bit, we are losing control on the settings of the bike. It's a bit more difficult on the new version to be able to set everything you want. Talking about the GPS now. So as I said, it's a great new feature to have the map displayed on the screen. We are close to get rid of the external additional device that you have to put on the bike. But so you can quite easily, you just need Bluetooth for that. You quite easily can have the instructions like this. The thing is that without the map, sometimes it's a bit difficult to know where you are and where you're going. So following these instructions are not that easy, and it is likely that you will make a lot of U-turns just using this. To be able to display the map on the bike, you have to connect your phone with Wi-Fi to the bike. That means every time you turn on the BMW Connected app, it will ask you this: would you like to join the network? You say yes. If you don't do that, during the whole ride, you will have this icon that will be blinking all the time. It's a bit annoying. Sometimes you lose the connection, you don't know why. You have to, anyway, whatever you want to the map to be displayed here or not, you have to leave the app using your position all the time. Otherwise, when you will be back on the bike, you will not have the instructions, you will not have the position of the bike. Sometimes it doesn't work, like just now. I don't know why it's not displayed. Ah yes, maybe if you lock your phone, it's over. So a few things that you have to get used to it that can be annoying. I don't know if you have heard, the compartment is ventilated because your phone can be frozen because it's too hot, especially while it's charging and while you're using it, navigating with the Wi-Fi connection. I don't know how it will work during the summer with 35-40 degrees out. Hopefully you will not be stuck or lost because your phone is too hot. Fingers crossed. So now you hear the ventilation. About the use of the GPS, if you want to set a new destination, you have to take the phone out, take your gloves off, and then you will be able to set a new destination. So I suggest you set the destinations off the bike and you use the recent destinations here. That's recent destinations in French, sorry. And here you have the latest destinations that have been set on your phone. So this will enable you to choose your next destination easily. And my recommendation is to buy gloves that will enable you to touch your screen without taking them off. Otherwise, it's a bit frustrating very quickly. So, as I said, we are close to get rid of the external GPS, but let's try. Let's give that a chance. At least we have a great phone charger here. One last thing I regret is the analog gauges. I like the needles, analog gauges for the speedometer or tachometer. It was not too bad on the previous generation. This screen was a TFT screen, small, yes, but it could have been bigger, so we could have displayed the map here, keeping the analog displays. So that's my opinion, of course. Please comment below to give your opinion. Please be respectful to others' opinion. Ah, by the way, no more antenna on the new RT. And one more thing is the horn of the new RT. That's the old one. So I don't know if people will look around after a bike or a 7 series or a X5 or... I don't know. Thanks a lot for your attention. Thanks a lot for watching. Please comment below if you have any questions. I will be happy to answer. Thank you. Bye.